We are here at Missouri Wind and Solar, where we are going to be spending a little bit of time talking about common myths and debunking some of those concerns that people have when it comes to both solar and wind power. I'm here with Wes, pretty much an expert when it comes to all of this stuff. Wes, what are we going to talk about here today?
So we get a lot of questions, a lot of comments even, if you will, about solar and what people think it does and doesn't do. And so we wanted to take a minute and just kind of go over some of those and kind of put some legs on some answers to that. You know, one of the first ones being is, you know, even like the fragility of a solar panel. So this is just a little array we've had out in front of the store for several years. And we wanted to talk about how these are tested for being out in the elements. So obviously one of the things that happens if you've got solar out on your roof or out on arrays like this is that in Missouri or anywhere else, you've got snow, you've got ice, you've got hail. And this is our hail piece. What we're gonna do is just take and throw that on the solar panel and just let you see. Now it put a little chip in there, which is great, because what they do, so the way solar panels are tested is basically, most of them are tested with two different underwriter laboratory processes. And one is they take a steel ball from a certain height and they just let it drop.
Okay.
And they just let it hit the panel and see what happens. And the other, which I would really like to see sometime, is that they fire, I think it's 13 to 15 1-inch ice balls at it with a pneumatic air gun. So I think that'd be a hoot to go see. And so they shoot it at strategic places on the solar panel. Now it's not looking to see that there's not damage. Like I said, if we zoomed in here, you'd see the tiniest little chip where I toss a rock. But it's that the solar panel continues to generate within its range of what it's supposed to be able to generate.
Right, and I know some people are also concerned that these cause a lot of waste. You know, worst case scenario, these things get obliterated. What happens with them then?
Right now, so that's another big thing we get is that, well, these are just clogging up the landfills and that sort of thing. The big thing, and I always like to contrast when people talk about solar and wind, is taking and contrasting that to something like a coal-fired plant, where you have tons and tons of coal ash that come out of it every day, and there's nothing you can do with coal ash except try to bury it in the ground and hope to God that it doesn't get into your water supply. With the solar panels right now, there are several companies, and the one that I'm thinking of in France in particular, I believe is named Rossi, is doing a lot of work on being able to recover the metal that is actually in the solar panel. So there's a lot of good metal, aluminum and other things like that, that are part of this, that is actually something that they are working very diligently to be able to reclaim. And I feel like that's something that's going to happen in the next couple of years, particularly as solar has become so much more popular
and become
so much more common. It's going to be like your soda cans that you get.
All right. And then finally, we're doing this whole series on these myths because people have a lot of questions. So if people have questions for you and they want to directly get in touch with you, how can they do that?
Absolutely. Always give our sales guys a call. We're here to answer your questions. 417-708-5359. One of the best things that you can do is attend one of our workshops.
Okay.
We're trying to put on we used to have just our long 2-day workshop. So we're trying to introduce some shorter workshops on a weeknight so folks can come over for a couple hours and kind of get a good overview. But we have once a quarter workshops that are for 2 days, go into a lot of detail, how to do it yourself sort of thing. And then our website has tons of resources, and our YouTube channel has tons of videos out there that we've done over the years, really going into the depth on a lot of these things.
All right, and for those of you at home, we are gonna put a link to their website right here at the bottom of your screen. Wes, as always, thanks for all of that great information and for having us out today.
Thanks for coming, Mason. Appreciate you being here.